This is not good. It's Dot and my fellow Webtective,
better known as her best friend,
Michaela.
Hello.
Y'all, we've got a huge problem. The third member of our investigation team has gone radio silent.
Alex has stopped talking to us.
It's worse than that. He left me on red.
Who would do that?
Clearly something is up. So we decided to take a look back at the last time he responded to either of us to see if we can figure out why he's upset.
We both last heard from Alex a couple of days ago in a group text after school.
Hello? Anybody there?
Oh, hey. Sorry I missed your text. I just got out of journalism club.
Snore. Sleeping face emoji.
I haven't heard from either of you all day. Are we still hanging out tonight?
LOL, Michaela. I happen to enjoy journalism club, so I was wide awake.
Nerdy glasses emoji. Winky face emoji.
Hello?
Oh, sorry, Alex. Yeah, we can hang out, or not. Whatever you guys want.
Well, can we decide? I've got some other things I have to do if we don't.
Which means working on your toy war model.
That thing is fire emoji.
Wow, aren't you two such great friends?
Gee, thanks. Squinty smile emoji.
I don't get it. We were so nice.
So nice. But I guess Alex didn't read it that way.
He must have read it totally different than we intended.
This is just like that thing we talked about in church.
Yeah, you're going to have to elaborate on that.
Oh, the pastor was talking about misreading the Bible, not text messages.
Okay, and that is the same how?
You know, how one person can read a verse in the Bible one way, and a different person can read it and think something totally different. It kind of seems like Alex read the text messages in a way that we didn't. So in order to figure out what went wrong, we need to... I feel a mystery coming on. You know what that means. We've got a case to crack. Looks like we've got a mistake of fact on our hands.
In English, please.
It's basically a criminal defense term that means the whole thing is just a big misunderstanding. Alex is ghosting us because he read a different meaning into our text messages. So we need help understanding how to rightly interpret written messages so we can figure out what went wrong.
Seems convoluted, but fun. Where do we start?
If we can figure out how to best interpret the Bible, then it'll be easier to interpret trivial things like text messages.
That one looks good.
Have you ever wondered how someone can read a verse of the Bible and read it one way, and someone else can read that same verse and read it totally differently?
Yes.
Have you ever wondered how understanding the Bible might really help you live your life now?
Yes.
Hi, I'm Darrell Bock, Executive Director for Cultural Engagement at the Hendricks Center and Senior Research Professor of New Testament Studies. And I'd like to invite you to attend.
This is just the lead we needed. Invitation accepted.
What invitation?
To take this case on the road. Okay, so I sent an email to Dr. Bock, and believe it or not, he agreed to meet with us.
More like 8 emails and you gave him no choice.
He's only got a few minutes between classes, so we're gonna catch up to him at the campus library to grill him for information.
Or, you know, just chat.
Should we do like a good cop, bad cop thing?
What? No.
By no, do you mean yes?
Nobody's a cop. This is just a casual interview.
Gotcha.
Did you just wink at the camera?
No!
You're totally doing it! Give me that!
Hey guys, we're here, minus Alex, of course, with Dr. Darrell Bock. To learn more about interpretation.
Hello, y'all.
Shh. Oh, we have to keep it down. We're in the library.
Dr. Bock, what makes different people interpret written messages in different ways?
Well, there's a word we have that's called hermeneutics. It's how to do right interpretation.
Herman who now?
Shh.
Sorry.
May I?
What we know is the Bible is a collection of books written by multiple authors spanning hundreds and hundreds of years. The two primary written languages of those authors were Hebrew and Greek, with a little Aramaic sprinkled in the Old Testament. Neither of which, you notice, are English. So we already have to work with a proper translation of the original manuscripts. But I'll save all that for another time.
Oh, sorry. I'm going to give you four letters to remember hermeneutics by. A-A-C-L. A is for author. That's who does the writing. That's whose message you want to understand. The second A is for audience. That's who he's speaking to. That's who needs to understand what he's saying. C is context. That's what you're talking about. And then L is the lens through which you are reading the material. So when someone takes a Bible verse and ignores the author, audience, context, and lens, they are in danger of misunderstanding what the original intent of that verse was. Considering the author, the audience, the context, and the lens are principles of interpretation that you could also call hermeneutics.
Okay, so this is really helpful. See, we've got a friend who misinterpreted text messages from us.
We're trying to figure out how to help him understand what we actually meant. How can hermeneutics help us?
Unfortunately, my expertise is not with adolescent relationships. I work with ancient texts. And your friend, I take it he's alive.
Oh, yes. Alex is very much alive and very much upset. We just don't know why.
Well, I'm actually late for class, but you might just try talking to him. And I wish you all the best as you reconcile with your friend.
Just talk to him? If only it were that simple. We should just talk to him, shouldn't we?
Definitely. He's the only person who can help solve this case, and I know exactly how to get his attention. Let's roll.
Is everything okay? Are you hurt?
Hi, Alex.
Don't hang up.
I don't understand. Your text said it was a matter of life and death.
It is.
Not really.
Okay, maybe we're not literally in danger, but our friendship is a big deal. And we needed to talk to you because we realize a big mistake has been made.
And that is?
We all failed to use good hermeneutics.
Hermen what?
Principles of interpretation. We think you were interpreting our texts in ways we didn't intend. And we don't know how it sounded to you exactly.
It sounded like you guys were annoyed by me and then made fun of my hobby.
What? Really?
Yeah, listen. Hello? Is anybody there? Oh, hey, sorry I missed your text. I just got out of journalism club. Snore. Sleeping face emoji. I didn't hear from either of you all day. Are we still hanging out? LOL, Michaela. I happen to enjoy journalism club, so I was wide awake. Nerdy glasses emoji, winky face emoji. Hello? Sorry, Alex, but yeah, we can hang out or not. Whatever you guys want. Can we decide? I've got some other things to do if we don't. Which means working on your toy war model. That thing is disaster emoji. Well, aren't you two such great friends? Gee, thanks, squinty smile emoji.
I had no idea.
We are so sorry. Also, it's fire emoji, not disaster emoji. You know, like it's fire or awesome.
Oh, is that what that's supposed to mean?
Alex. You know we don't think you're annoying, and I actually do think your war models are cool.
It's a diorama, actually, not a toy. And it is a cool one. They are Dean counteroffensive.
We should have realized you were texting in ways that showed you were frustrated.
I realize that now, too. And we're sorry.
Will you forgive us?
Of course. And I'm sorry, too. I should have assumed the best in you since you are my friends. So, you want to come over and help me finish the diorama?
Actually, I'm just about to go live in a little bit to give an update on the case.
I put off some homework that I've got to finish before it gets too late.
Oh, okay, cool. No worries.
But I've definitely got time tomorrow. Dot?
Sounds great. If that works for you, Alex.
Field Marshal Walter Model is anxious to meet you. Okay, it's a little weird, isn't it?
Yeah, kinda.
We can do whatever. It's cool. See you tomorrow.
Bye.
So,
Turns out that things got a little lost in translation with Alex. That can happen to any of us when we don't consider the author, audience, or context of a message, or the lens you read it through. You know what? I realized something else. I need to be careful when I'm interpreting anything that I read, especially the most important historical text message thread known as the Bible. Because the better I can do hermeneutics, the better I can understand what God is trying to teach me. And that's the solution to this case. Good interpretation requires good hermeneutics. I think we can close the book on this case, Webtectives. I've got some homework to do, so that's it for me today. Remember, the truth is out there. We just gotta go find it. Catch you later.